first week of winter is almost done, and if you're one of the many Aussies planning to escape to the Sunshine State, you may want to hold off. Parts of Queensland have shivered through their coldest morning since last winter, with some places dropping below zero. This is very serious.
Wow.
Earlier this week, Brisbane recorded an overnight temperature of 7 degrees, Ipswich plummeted to 2 degrees.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Here to explain how Queenslanders are dealing with these devastating temperatures is human weather vane and oracle of everything. It's Mel Buttle. Mel, I cannot imagine what you're going through at the moment. How have you been coping?
Thanks, Georgie. Yeah. Look, I've been struck down financially. It's been tough. I've had to go and buy a jumper. I've had to wear layers, and usually I don't even wear socks. Socks are reserved for visits to Hobart or running marathons. And look, it's been hard to go to the gym in the mornings, but to be honest, I stopped doing that in 2003 anyway.
So. Thoughts and prayers, Mel. Thoughts and prayers. Now, what kind of effect is this having on the local community in Brisbane?
I haven't been able to say the phrase, hot enough for you, mate, for over 3 days. Thank you, guys. And it's tough to talk about. So as a Queenslander, I don't know a lot of other ways to start off conversations. Mm. So, you know, you can always cut someone off in traffic and not wave. That normally gets them going. I've sort of had enough of the weather. Enough is enough. Can we please have some of the daylight that you all saved up with your special made-up Melbourne communist time? It's not 2 o'clock, it's 3 o'clock. Oh, all right, look, take your meds and stop fiddling around with what time my Zoom calls start. Thank you.
God, communist Melbourne, I love it. All right. Now, I've been to Queensland. What I'm worried about, Mel, is just Queensland, does it have
amazing.
I've travelled. What I want to know, Mel, is does Queensland have the infrastructure, this is serious, infrastructure to survive these kinds of conditions?
Oh. Thanks for the question, Mr. Media. Look, our houses are set up to be cool, not warm.
Yeah.
We don't have fireplaces, which you would have seen on your tour. we've got pools, so how is that meant to keep me warm? Should I put some petrol on the top of the pool and light it? Help me, Southerners. What are we meant to do in winter for fun? Like, what do you guys do in Melbourne? Do you go to the theatre or check out an AFL game, or more likely vote Greens and drink coffee afternoon? Got ya.
This is an attack.
Surely, Mel, this is going to have disastrous effects on Queensland's winter tourism.
Thank you, Kate. Look, it says on the number plates in Queensland, the Sunshine State. Now, that's a lie, isn't it? It's a lie. It should say Queensland. Ask Dad if you're allowed to turn the heat on.
I'm scared about what the answer might be to this one, Mel, but is climate change to blame for this?
Well, as my boomer uncle says, why is it getting colder when it's meant to be global warming? To be honest, great question, Warren. Look, I don't have time to explain global warming, but I do know something, Uncle Warren. Your password for Facebook is password.
Mel, Mr. Media here, back again. What does this mean for Brisbane's future?
We like it hot here, Mr. Media, and that's... That's what we've got to offer the world is weather. We've got weather, we've got a nice beach. So please don't take the warm weather from us, because what have we got left then? We've got nothing. We would be perfect.
Oh, God.
Mel, we are with you throughout all of this. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
For taking it through. Yeah. It's tough. It's a tough time. Yeah.